The creators of the movie Jurassic Park used sounds from a baby elephant, alligator, and tiger combined to bring the dinosaur roar to life. Audiences loved it, but scientists, not so much. Hey there, terror lizards. Trace here for DNews. Dinosaurs have been gone for 65 million years, so no human has ever heard one roar. Never. In the movies, dinosaurs had sustained echoing howls, but in real life, nah, bro. A paper from 2009's Historical Biology attempted to reveal exactly what some of these animals may have sounded like, and let me tell you, T-Rex probably didn't roar. Instead, the king of the dinosaurs may have just said, hiss, or maybe nothing at all. First, there is no fossilized evidence of dinosaur voice boxes. Voice boxes are made of flesh, so they don't fossilize, and thus, we will probably never know without a shadow of a doubt what these animals really sounded like. But paleontologist Phil Center researched the vocalizations of living dinosaurian relatives to try and make an educated guess. 66 million years ago, at the end of the Mesozoic era, most dinosaurs went extinct in the KT extinction event. 95% of the birds we have today, according to their DNA, evolved from any small dinosaurs not killed by the KT event. 10 million years after that, the first shared ancestor of all living modern crocodiles evolved, and they've remained relatively unchanged ever since. So, by looking at birds and crocodiles, scientists figure we might find some hint at what dinosaurs sounded like. To roar, animals have to have a voice box, and in the case of crocs and birds, they come in different types. Crocs use a larynx, the same kind of organ as you and me. Birds use a little different organ called a syrinx, which generates birdsong. Dr. Julia Clark of the University of Texas at Austin told me in an email, the syrinx had no precursor organ. It evolved with birds after dinosaur extinction. And from fossil evidence, we know the larynx did the same. So because birds and crocs and their voice boxes evolved after the mass extinction of dinosaurs, researchers posit their commonly shared ancestor dinosaur probably couldn't vocalize at all. Essentially, we know dinosaurs didn't roar because they didn't evolve voice boxes until later, as far as we know. But just because they didn't roar doesn't mean they didn't make noise. A paper in Anatomical Record points out many dinosaurs had nasal cavities, mouths, and connective noses. This connection inside of the skull created resonance chambers, which allows animals to create all sorts of sounds even without the larynx or syrinx. And literally on top of that, the Lambiosaurus and Hadrosaurus had massive resonating crests connected to their breathing tracts, which researchers think could amplify those noises even further. We've found fossils of these crests so they can prove it, and some researchers blew air through them to show that they could have produced low-frequency sounds just like modern crocs and some elephants. So even though they didn't roar, dinosaurs could have drummed, groaned, hissed, gurgled, clicked, rattled, chirped, and chirruped, just like their modern relatives. Calling out that you're the best at hunting or mating is super important in the animal world, that's why we vocalize, but calling out your portfolio of photos, books, or Kanye GIFs and GIFs is super important in the internet world. What better way to do that than with your own website? And no domain extension will help you tell your story like a .com or .net domain name. Because you watch DNews, you can get 15% off domain.com's names and web hosting. Use the code DNews when you check out, and it'll help the show too, so thanks. If you're looking for more dinosaur stuff, you should take a second to watch my other science show and podcast, Test Tube Plus. Over on TTP, we dive deep into the controversy of the earliest dino discoveries, how some dinosaurs that you know might not actually be real, the black market of dinosaur fossils, and how we might even be able to bring these bad boys back. And according to Professor of History of Science and Technology at Keele University in the UK, Hugh Torrens, Owen's key contribution was not just dreaming up this cool, charismatic name, Terrible Lizard, which they aren't, so Owen, come on, man. They're not even lizards. Does it bother you when Hollywood makes stuff up about dinosaurs, like why didn't velociraptors have feathers in the movies? Dinosaurs had feathers? It's made up. Let me know your thoughts down in the comments, and please subscribe to DNews. You'll get all of our videos. We make them every day, all week.